Please be seated.
Le président, veuillez vous asseoir.
The court is now in session.
L'audience est ouverte.
Mr. Doug Parry is now directed to report to the chamber on the current status of the parties to the proceedings today.
Veuillez faire état de la présence des parties à la procédure.
Doug Parry, good morning, Mr. President, and your honors.
Bonjour, Monsieur parties le Président, to the proceedings Mesdames today are juges, all present. L'ensemble des parties
Mr.
Nuntia
is present in his holding cell downstairs,
dans sa cellule de détention temporaire au sous-sol.
As ruled by the trial chamber due
conformément
to his
à la décision
concerns.
De la chambre en raison
During
de
today's
santé.
Sessions, we have a reserve witness, TCW.
Le témoin
TCE
is de réserve,
33.
TCE.
This witness
33
is available to be called in the afternoon.
Est disponible et
this
pourra être appelé cet après-midi, le cas échéant.
To the best of his knowledge,
ce témoin a déjà confirmé
the witness is not in a relationship with an accused or a civil
ne
party.
Pas avoir de lien
the witness will take the oath before the chamber when the witness appears
les accusés
before the chamber.
Civiles.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Le témoin prêtera
the
serment.
President. Thank you, Mr. Doug Parry. Next, the chamber
le
would
président,
like to
merci.
Now hand over to counsel for Mr. Nuntia to continue.
La parole va maintenant être donnée à
Making
la défense de Nuntia,
regarding their responses to the presentation of the key documents presented by the co-prosecutors and the legal lawyers for the civil parties on the 24th and 27th of June.
You may now proceed. Vous avez la parole.
Counsel Son Arun, good morning, Mr. President,
Arun.
And your honors.
Bonjour, Monsieur le Président, Mesdames et Messieurs les juges.
I would like to continue from what we left off yesterday late afternoon regarding our responses to the key documents presented by the co-prosecutors.
Dans nos réponses aux documents clés présentés par les co-procureurs.
Today, I am discussing about S21.
Et aujourd'hui, je vais parler de S21.
Your Honours,
I
would like
to
turn now to S21.
J'en viens maintenant à S21.
I would like to first repeat the objections made by my colleague, Mr.
Copé,
yesterday morning.
Matin.
It makes no sense that we were talking in this document presentation hearing about Nuntia's role at S21, which is outside the scope of this trial.
Ce qui ne rentre pas dans le champ de ce procès.
This chamber has twice refused the prosecution's request to include S21 within the scope of this trial. Nuntia's role at S21 is not about his role in relation to an alleged CPK policy.
Une quelconque politique
it is about
PCK
his role at
role
a crime site.
Il s'agit de son rôle
there is not enough evidence
crime.
Before this court to make any findings on this subject.
Les preuves produites devant
there
cette
are
chambre
several topics on which this chamber would need to hear live testimony in order to make findings about Nuntia's role at S21. Those topics include, for example, the President, Counsel, can you please hold on? And Mr. Co-Prosecutor, you may now proceed.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning to everybody. Counsel is again straying from the purpose of this present of this hearing, which is to respond to the documents that have been presented. He's now making an argument relating to whether or not S21 is part of the case, whether testimony, additional testimony would be required about S21. He's not responding to the documents. I would refer him to closing order paragraphs 877, 878, and 879, which are part of this case. All three paragraphs directly concern one subject, Nunchea's responsibility for S21. Nevertheless, the purpose of these hearings is not to argue about the scope of trial. The purpose of these hearings is for the defense to respond to the documents we presented.
De permettre à la défense de répondre aux documents que nous avons présentés.
Counsel Sonaron, Mr. President, please allow me to respond to the comment made by the co-prosecutor. This is just part of the introduction. Before I proceed to our response to the co-prosecutor's submissions, because first we should begin with the introduction before we come to the body and the conclusion. With that, may I ask for your leave to proceed, please?
Au sujet qui nous concerne, permettez-moi de répondre ou de poursuivre plutôt.
The President. Counsel San Arun, please be informed that the Chamber has already informed the parties to the proceeding regarding the topic for the hearing, and the Chamber has just indicated that counsels from Mr. Nunjie would proceed to make observation regarding their responses to the key documents presented by the parties to the proceedings, including the co-prosecutors and the lead co-lawyers for the civil parties. Documents presented during the hearings on the 24 to the 27th of June 2013. It was a week ago, so the message is clear. Could you please now be directed to frame your observation to be in line with the agenda the Chamber has already notified the parties? And please refrain from making things that are not relevant to this part. Otherwise, you are straying away from the main agenda of today's hearing.
Du sujet Counsel Son Arun, lors de cette audience.
I am rather stunned by this because co-prosecutors would also need to go through some introduction before they could proceed to the body. The President, indeed, it is on your side, you appear to
de formuler leurs
be
propos.
Irrelevant regarding
en
this.
Effet,
yesterday, you were already been reminded regarding
de pertinence. Hier,
the
on vous a déjà rappelé
general scheme of your observation. And you mentioned about some five key documents,
and
then you dwelled on other general aspects before you went through these five documents. People understood your position differently. So to make sure that we are not misled, then please proceed to only the relevant part of the observation regarding the responses to the prosecution and civil party lawyers.
Counsel Sonaron,
thank you, Mr. President. I would like to now proceed to the actual responses.
Je vais donc passer à mes réponses.
The co-prosecutor's evidence about Nguyen Chi's role at S21 was almost entirely about S21 confessions. The prosecution described 26 confessions with annotations which allegedly show that those confessions were sent to Nguyen Chi. Then they showed you 6 confessions with annotations which they claim were made by Nguyen Chi. The prosecution says that these documents show that Nguyen Chi had a role at
S21.
Your Honours, we submit that the documentary evidence presented by the co-prosecutors does not support that claim in any way. In fact, we would submit that if the evidence shows anything, it shows that Nguyen Chi had no role at S21 at all. In order to prove that, I will first discuss the 6 confessions which the co-prosecutors claim contain annotations made by Nguyen Chi. I will then discuss the confessions which were allegedly forwarded to
Nguyen Chi.
I would like to begin examining the prosecution's claim that Nguyen Chi annotated 6 S21 confessions by examining one of those confessions in detail. That confession is from a cadre named San Yip. The document number is E3-175. According to the prosecution, Dutch has testified that one small annotation on the site was made by Nguyen Chi. Is that true? To answer that question, I would like to show the chamber a document. The document number is E3-359. It contains Deutsch's answer to certain written questions. This is a document in which the prosecution claims Deutsch identifies the annotation on San Yip's confession as belonging to Nguyen Chi. I would refer the chamber to ERN English 00043439, ERN 00408224. At the bottom of that page, at point 11,
Dutch
writes the following about that confession.
Voici ce qu'écrit Deutsch concernant
document D43-4. In case file 002, I have just received document D43-4 in case file 002, and it is the sole Zone 801 special branch document that I have ever seen. So Dutch has not, in fact, testified that Nguyen Chi made this annotation. He has not testified to that fact because he had never seen the document before the day the investigating judges showed it to him. Rather, Dutch is only able to tell this chamber whether the annotation on this document looks like Nguyen Chi's handwriting. Now, as the chamber knows, Dutch is not an expert in handwriting. He is not able to give this court his opinion about whether 2 different handwriting samples look alike. He is only able to tell the chamber whether he specifically remembers and can personally identify Mr. Nunjie's handwriting. Your Honours, in interpreting the prosecution's claim that Dutch personally remembers what Nunjie's handwriting looks like, we would like to invite you to exercise some common sense. Dutch claims he last saw Nunjie in 1979. Dutch was interviewed by the investigating judges for the first time in 2007, almost 30 years passed in between. We would ask your honors to put yourselves in Dutch's position. We would like to invite the members of the public gallery to do the same. Would you remember what your boss' handwriting looked like 30 years after you last saw him? As this chamber knows well, Dutch is an intelligent and well-informed witness. He studied the case 001 case file extensively. He followed the developments surrounding this tribunal very carefully. Your honors may be aware that earlier this year, former investigating judge Marcel Lemonde wrote a book about his experience at this tribunal. Even judge Lemonde recalls that it was often difficult to figure out whether Dutch was testifying from memory. The president, could you please hold on, counsel?
Le président, veuillez attendre.
Mr. Co-Prosecutor, you may
Monsieur
now proceed.
Monsieur le Co-Procureur, allez-y.
Thank you, Mr. President. I would object to counsel's presentation of this document, which was rejected by the trial chamber, and it's entirely inappropriate for counsel to be standing here making representations about what Judge Lemon's views were in any event. So this is not a document that is been admitted, not a document that can be presented to your honors.
N'a pas été admis et ne devra pas être présenté à la chambre.
Counsel Son Arun.
Maître Son Arun.
Mr. President, would you wish me to skip to another paragraph,
Monsieur
or would you wish me to respond to the co-prosecutor's comment? The President, it is your sole right to respond to the co-prosecutor's remarks, because the chamber would wait for this moment before we finally rule upon this objection. If you would like to skip to the next paragraph, then you can do that on your own volition. And again, this document, as indicated, has never been presented before the chamber by any parties of the proceedings, including the co-prosecutors, the lead co-lawyers for the civil parties, during the entire time in the courtroom, in document hearing in particular on the 24th to 27th.
June 2013.
Counsel Sonarun, with that, Mr. President, I may skip the part on Judge Marcel Lemonde, and I would proceed to another paragraph.
Passer sur mes commentaires concernant le livre du juge Lemonde. Je vais passer à un autre sujet.
Mr. President and your honors, again, we ask you to exercise some common sense. Is it more likely that Deutsch actually remembers what Nguyen Chi's handwriting looks like 30 years after the last time he saw it? Or is it more likely that he inferred that the markings on the confessions belong to Nguyen Chi because he was told so many times about Nguyen Chi's role in the interview, rather in the intervening years? Your Honours, we think the answer to this question is obvious. We think it is extremely unlikely that Deutsch has an independent recollection of Nguyen Chi's handwriting. However, the chamber need not rely on our opinion. It need not even exercise its own common sense. Deutsch himself has told this tribunal that he cannot recognize Nguyen Chi's handwriting. And to show that, I would like to display document number E3/355. This document is a written record of interview of Deutsch in case 002. It was taken the day before Deutsch answered the questions which we saw just a moment ago. In that interview, Deutsch talks about the same confession belonging to San
Iep
at ERN in Khmer 0023 98 34 and English ERN 0024 28 76. Deutsch notes the annotation which the prosecution says is written by Nguyen Chi. He says the following: I don't know who wrote that,
j'ignore qui l'a écrit,
but it was not Pol Pot,
mais ce n'était pas Pol
whose
Pot.
Handwriting was similar to mine.
Dans l'écriture ressemblait à la mienne.
Like Sun Sen's and Von Wait.
Tout comme celle de Sun Sen et de Von Wait.
Perhaps Nguyen Chi wrote it. But that is just my assumption, because I did not see this handwriting often.
Part, car je n'ai pas souvent vu son écriture.
Your Honours, this is a statement of the man whose evidence is the only basis this tribunal has ever been given to conclude that Nguyen Chi annotated any
dans les témoignages 21 confessions.
We would ask the chamber to take note of the fact that Deutsch has specific recollections of the handwriting of Pol Pot, Von Wait, and Sun Sen. Yet he is unable to make any independent determinations about Nguyen Chi's handwriting. It would seem then not only that Deutsch was not accustomed to receiving written instructions from Nguyen Chi, it would also seem that he interacted more often with other senior members of the Khmer Rouge regime. In other documents in which the prosecution says Deutsch identifies annotations as belonging to Nguyen Chi, it is equally clear that he has no real basis on which to make that conclusion. For example, in document E3/1547, another written record of interview, Deutsch discusses the confession of Mia Tuch alias Kem. My apologies, Mr. President and Your Honor. I would like to read this number of document again. This document is E3/1547, which is another written report of interview. Deutsche discusses the confession of Meyer Deutsch alias Kahn. There was another one of the confessions presented by the prosecution last week at ERN-017-4100 and English ERN-007-1346. Deutsch claims to know that Nguyen Chia made the annotation.
Deutsch prétend savoir
Comrade
que a écrit
quote unquote,
Camarade Van,
on the side of the confession. How does he say that he knows that? The only way he says he knows that is,
comment
he claims,
savoir,
that if Son Sen had addressed Insari, he would have written, in quote, Brother Van, end of quote, instead
si
of, quote, Comrade Van, end of quote.
S'adressait à Yang Sari, il aurait écrit Frère Van et non pas Camarade
But only
Van.
Seconds later, on the same page of the interview, up on the screen,
à la même page du
he admitted, and I quote, I do not know the details of how the superiors worked together. As we have seen, he also concedes that he rarely saw Nguyen Chia's writing. The obvious truth is that he has no idea how either Nguyen Chia or Son Sen spoke to Yang Sari. In the three other documents in which the prosecution claims, Deutsch identifies annotations as belonging to Nguyen Chia. Deutsch provides no explanation at all for his conclusion. And for the benefit of the chamber, those are document number E3/ 1546,
ERN-0017-3049, and 0017-3049.
This document is in relation to the confession of Mok Sam-ol alias
Ce
Hong,
document
E3/1548, and Khmer,
ERN-0017-4132,
and English 0076-7463, in relation to the confession of San Po, and E3/1098,
my ERN-0000-406602,
and English 00524161,
et en anglais 00524161.
The President. Mr. Arun, you haven't given the ER number in French.
Vous ne donnez pas
because,
les
look,
parties
to the proceedings would include French nationals
Nous
as well, so you should also refer to the French ER number if you can.
Les ERN en français.
Please turn on the mic.
Le président, maître, veuillez
Council.
Allumer votre micro.
My apology, Mr. President. I
maître
do not have the French ERN with me at the moment. I only have English and Khmer ERN. The President, you may now resume.
Le président, vous pouvez continuer.
President, Judge Jean-Marc Lavergne, you may proceed.
Mais la parole est d'abord donnée au juge Jean-Marc Lavergne.
Maître Sonnaroun, je comprends qu'aujourd'hui, vous n'avez pas eu le temps de bien préparer votre audience, donc c'est la raison pour laquelle vous n'avez pas pu trouver les références en français. Mais est-ce que nous pouvons espérer que prochainement, vous communiquiez ces renseignements à la Chambre?
Merci.
Maître Sonnaroun.
Counsel Sonnaroun, my
Je
apology,
mes excuses.
Your Honours. I am going to provide this relevant ERN's number at a later stage.
Ces ERN seront communiqués ultérieurement.
Yeah. Est-ce qu'on peut dire que
Can
dans deux jours,
Counsel
vous pouvez nous
that, you will be able to give us this information within
D'ici
2 days?
Deux jours, est-ce possible?
Within 2 days, would that be possible?
Ban.
Maître Sonnaroun,
yes,
oui.
Of course, Your Honor.
Bien sûr.
May I continue, Mr. President?
Je
Only one
continue.
Thing is clear in those documents.
Dans ces documents,
Deutsch
une seule
has
chose
no specific
claire.
Recollection of
C'est
any of those
Duke
confessions
ne se souvient
or any
pas
actual knowledge at all about any of those annotations.
De ces aveux.
Your Honours, obviously this is
Et
an important allegation.
Il ne sait rien de précis concernant de telles annotations.
Mr. Nunchier has always consistently
Il s'agit
denied
d'une
it.
Allégation importante, de toute évidence.
The evidence supporting the allegation comes
Nunchier
from only one witness.
A toujours rejeté
And for the reason we have already stated,
celle-ci
that witness testimony is not reliable.
La déposition que d'un seul témoin.
Under these circumstances,
C'est pourquoi,
the chamber should, at a minimum, engage a handwriting expert before concluding that the annotations belong to Nunchier.
If
it does not choose to take that avenue, which is available to it, it would be unable to conclude beyond a reasonable doubt that the handwriting belongs
si
to Nunchier.
Ne procède pas de cette manière, elle ne saurait conclure au-delà du doute raisonnable que l'écriture
Your Honours,
est celle de
Nunchier. That concludes our discussion of the confession
voilà pour
which
la question
the prosecution
des aveux.
Alleges. Contain annotations written by Nunchier. And I will now discuss the rest of the confessions, the ones which
par
the prosecution
Je
says
aux
were sent to Nunchier.
Ceux dont l'accusation prétend
I would like to
qu'ils
begin by quoting something the prosecutors recently said.
Citer
the co-prosecutors recently filed a
Ceux-ci
submission with the Supreme Court Chamber about the severance of the closing order.
Une demande devant la Chambre de la Cour suprême concernant
we
la disjonction des poursuites.
Against
Il s'agissait
decision to
d'une
sever
réponse
the closing
à l'appel
order.
Que nous avons interjeté contre la deuxième décision de disjonction
E
de la présente Chambre. Je vous renvoie au document E-284-4-3.
ERN Khmer 00921840 and English 00921816. In that response, at paragraph 21, the co-prosecutors try to show that Nunchier had a role at S21.
Que Nunchier a joué un rôle particulier
and in doing that,
par rapport à
they talk about the confession.
Pour ce faire,
I'll
l'accusation
quote a sentence
les
from
aveux.
Their submission,
je vais citer une
which
phrase
is at paragraph
des
21.
Écritures de l'accusation,
quote,
au paragraphe 21.
The co-investigating judges found
Les co-juges d'instruction
at least
ont trouvé
27 confessions
au moins 27 documents
with
d'aveux
annotations
contenant
indicating
des
that
annotations
a copy
indiquant
was sent to
qu'une
Nunchier.
Copie a été envoyée
and another
à Nunchier.
Six S21
Ainsi
confessions
que
bearing
six autres
Nunchier's
aveux de S21
handwriting,
portant
quote.
l'écriture de Lun Xia. Fin de citation.
Mr. President, here is what we find interesting about this quote.
Cette citation présente
the co-prosecutors
un aspect
try
qui
to convince the chambers of this tribunal that because Nguyen Chia supposedly saw 33 confessions, that he must have had a role at S21.
Que Nguyen Chia so a dû jouer un rôle par rapport à S21 au
what
motif qu'il aurait vu 33 aveux.
Is 33 a lot?
33 aveux,
of
c'est
how
beaucoup?
Many confessions?
Ce sont 33 documents d'aveux sur combien?
How many confessions are
combien
on the
de
case
documents
file?
D'aveux ont-ils été placés au dossier?
We also concur with the prosecutor that these may have some relation with military structure, and this confession was sent to Nguyen Chia.
Militaire.
And the mere fact that this document was sent to Nguyen Chia, it was not because he had any role in S21, but this document was to be sent from the military authority, and Mr. Nguyen Chia might have already forgotten this information.
Que Nguyen Chia a oublié ces informations.
Đội lực lang thà.
And this document has been sent to Nguyen Chia, and
ces documents
the prosecutor claims that Mr. Nguyen Chia had a role in military structure, and he was involved in the purges of the military personnel. This was the quote that the prosecutor brought up on the 27th of June. Your Honor, to be clear, Mr. Nguyen Chia did not concur with the allegation that he had a role in purges of military personnel in the central zone. And I would like to draw attention of the chamber that even the prosecutor themselves failed to explain consistently the reason for the submission of these statements to Nguyen Chia. But this statement sent only from S21, or it was sent for other purposes. The document failed to enlighten the chamber on this, and I believe that the prosecutor themselves did not know. And for this reason, the chamber does not have any basis for the decision.
La chambre ne peut se fonder là-dessus.
Mr. President and Your Honours, I do not have any additional observation, and I would like to request to Mr. President and the Chamber that my client would like to make an observation on the various key documents presented by the prosecutor, and we are seeking permission from the bench, the President. Yes, he may proceed.
L'autorise à s'exprimer, le Président. Je vous en prie.
The President, Mr. Nguyen Chia, the Chamber grants you the opportunity to respond to the various key documents that have been put before the Chamber by the co-prosecutors and lead co-lawyers for the civil parties. You may proceed, Mr. Nguyen Chia.
Je vous en prie, Monsieur Nguyen Chia.
Mr. Nguyen Chia, I thank you very much indeed, Mr. President.
Merci beaucoup, Monsieur le Président.
Tungjane.
The President, every booth, can you advise the Chamber as to what problem we are facing technically?
Nous faire
it is important that we are informed so that we can proceed
quelle est la nature du problème.
Decide how to proceed.
Nous aimerions le savoir.
Mr. President, and your honors, I am Nguyen Chia. I would like to
Monsieur le Président, Mesdames, Messieurs les Juges,
make some statement in response to
Nguyen
the
je souhaite faire une déclaration
key documents presented by the co-prosecutors on the 24th through
de
the 27th of June 2013. Your Honours, during the past few days, commencing from the 24th to the 27th of June, from my holding cell downstairs, I attentively paid attention to the presentation of several documents by both the national and international co-prosecutors.
Lesquels ont été présentés par le coprocureur national et international.
Though I sometimes got what the prosecution submitted, There were times
parfois, j'ai
that
compris,
I could not follow what
parfois,
being discussed
je n'ai pas pu suivre
due
le fil
to
de la discussion
my poor health conditions.
En raison de mon mauvais état de santé.
Nonetheless, I understood enough to believe that
j'en ai suffisamment compris
what were raised by the prosecution
pour penser
appear to be neither accurate nor corresponding to the actual events
exact
that had happened during that period.
Avec les événements réels de la période considérée.
I would therefore like to grave your honor's indulgence, for I wish to enlighten the court on these matters.
J'aimerais donc apporter certains éclaircissements.
With that, I would like to contest the entirety of the
je
content and the form of documents presented by the prosecution
la
as follows.
Des documents de l'accusation du point de vue de la forme et du contenu.
First of all, I'd like to address the issue of A. Evacuation of the people.
L'évacuation de la population.
A few years ago, I already testified that
années,
after the Liberation Day of the 17th of April 1975, all city dwellers were evacuated.
Tous les citadins ont été
and it is
évacués.
Obvious. In any event,
cela
the
manifeste.
Evacuation was not forced.
L'évacuation n'a pas été forcée.
The leadership had to make such decisions based on two main reasons.
Pour deux raisons principalement.
First,
premièrement,
it was fear that Americans would drop bombs on cities after Lono's government was defunct.
Après
this made the leadership believe that the aerial bombardments would be carried out again onto the cities,
que les villes
especially the city of Phnom Penh.
En particulier la ville de Phnom Penh.
Your Honours, it is well known that the Americans supported Lon Nol's regime and South Vietnam,
que les Américains
while North Vietnam was in support of the Democratic Cambodia against
Nol,
South
Vietnam,
Vietnam and the Americans.
Le Cambodia démocratique contre le Vietnam Sud et les Américains.
As a consequence, the Americans believed that North Vietnam and the Democratic Cambodia were its enemies. For a period of 300 nights and days, the Americans had dropped several million tons of bombs onto Cambodia.
Sur le
territoire cambodgien. The destruction caused by the bombings was of mind-boggling scale, when properties,
des bombardements ont été
homes, pagodas, cattle
des maisons,
were hit,
des pagodes,
and several thousand of innocent lives
touchés,
were killed.
Et des
noting this unfortunate tragedy,
tués,
which would most likely happen again, and to ensure safety and
nous
security for the people,
tragédie se produise à nouveau, nous voulions
the leadership of
la sécurité
the Democratic
de la population.
Cambodia,
c'est pourquoi les dirigeants du Cambodia
Pol Pot
démocratique,
in particular,
et en particulier
decided
Pol Pot,
to evacuate the people from the cities.
La population des villes.
Second of all, Cambodia had gone through war for over 5 years already.
Cela faisait déjà 5 ans que le Cambodge
this made the country
était en guerre,
face several challenges,
Plusieurs problèmes ont découlé pour le pays,
including food shortages.
Y compris des pénuries alimentaires.
Food shortages were the primary concern to be addressed very urgently.
Le problème le plus urgent à régler.
At that time, Cambodia did not receive any aid or assistance from foreign countries. In the light of these dire circumstances, people were required to take part in rice production by themselves to support their livelihood and to build the country.
Pouvoir manger et édifier le pays.
In spite of the above-mentioned reasons, the evacuation
Malgré
of the people at that time was done on a voluntary basis without any coercive measures, violence, or killing of the people.
N'a été prise, il n'y a pas eu de violence,
to maintain this principle, people were educated and well explained about the danger of the Americans' aerial bombardments
le danger
on cities and the need to resolve food
villes,
shortages ainsi que la nécessité for the livelihood of the people and for building the country ourselves.
Les populations puissent subvenir à leurs besoins
At that time, people appreciated the danger the country faced and its need.
Des dangers auxquels était confronté
In particular,
le pays.
People supported and loved the revolution.
Les gens soutenaient et aimaient la révolution.
Eventually, people gradually had left the cities after they had received our appeal and explanation to do so.
Après avoir entendu notre appel
Your Honours,
et nos explications.
I would wish to bring to your attention
Mesdames,
some
Messieurs
documents
juges,
that
attirer votre attention
are
sur
improper
certains documents.
And that cannot be used as the basis for the Chamber's consideration and its ruling to find justice for me and the victims.
En vue de rendre justice à moi-même et aux victimes.
These documents include,
Parmi
first,
ces documents, il y a
the revolutionary flags. The co-prosecutors submitted based on some information regarding the revolutionary flags as the inculpatory evidence against me. Factually, the revolutionary flags had nothing to do with me. The reason I say so because the revolutionary flags were the medical messages, rather the political messages by the senior leaders of the regime. These magazines were not legal documents that had to be applied. Before the victory on the 17th of April 1975, as well as the aftermath of that liberation, that message, the political message in the magazines, were very important to gather the forces of the Democratic Cambodia, because Cambodia, during that period of time, indeed after the internal war, was over, there were wars in which neighboring country, including Vietnam, invaded Cambodia. Vietnam never wanted Cambodia to be in peace. They used or employed all dirty tricks and tactics to topple Cambodia. For that reason, Pol Pot had to release political
C'est
messages
Pol
in the magazines to show the people
revue.
That the leadership was still strong, firm, and that most of the time the information is not accurate.
Et la plupart du temps, ces informations n'étaient pas exactes.
If we look carefully into the content of the revolutionary flag magazines, we can note that the majority of the articles published in these newspapers or magazines were mainly the statements by Pol Pot and the reports collected from each sector or zone across the country. This has already been confirmed in the references the co-prosecutors referred to in the hearings from the 24th to the 27th of June 2013. As a principle, the Revolutionary Flag magazines were examined by the standing of the Central Committee. Nonetheless, it was Pol Pot alone who made all the decisions before any articles could be published. So, all in all, the decision was made not by collective but by Pol Pot. He himself had his own personal assistant who was fully in charge of writing the articles and publication of these magazines. I still remember that there is another person by the name of Gum Won, alias Chaum, who worked in this group. At that time, even though the members of the Central Committee didn't see the right thing being said, no one would dare to challenge such a decision. Pol Pot had all the power, absolute power. Whatever he said, he meant business.
Quand il disait quelque chose, il ne plaisantait pas.
In the socialist regime, the people who had all the most power had the decision on the fate of the country, and it was only one person who was behind all the decisions. It was the secretary of the party.
Your Honours,
I am interested in the accuracy of the documents being put by the co-prosecutor regarding this document, including the revolutionary flag. And the main point that I wish to draw your attention to is the original documents
the prosecutor
put before the chamber. On this point, I already made my submission time and again from the very beginning that documents of original source had to be placed before the chamber or showed to me, but all to no avail. I don't understand much about the rule of evidence, but I fully understand what justice is.
En ce qui concerne les règles de preuve, mais je comprends
so far,
très bien les règles
the co-prosecutors presented some documents which were mainly inculpatory documents, and they were the copied version. I believe it is not fair for me to be presented such copied documents, because after all, no one knows whether these documents are genuine or they were the fake ones. On top of that, if the chamber allows such documents to be examined, there were chances that the document could be fabricated or changed easily, and justice will be compromised. And the truth will never be found.
Et ainsi, la vérité ne sera jamais connue.
I would like to absolutely take issue with all the documents presented by the co-prosecutors against me.
Donc fortement
secondly,
à l'ensemble des documents
the citation of documents from books.
À ma charge.
According
Deuxième
to or in these proceedings, I have also noted that several articles from
débats,
books were quoted by the co-prosecutors against me. These books include the books from Mr. Philip Short, Mr. David Chandler, Mr. Poncho François, and Mr. Ben Kiernan, etc.
etc.
When it comes to this point, I feel I am stunned and I don't understand why the co-prosecutors resort to using such documents as the core documents against me. Factually, these books, although there are pieces of document inside, they are not 100% true. The quality of truth in that is questionable. In general, in order to make sure the book can be can convince the readers, the authors had to apply some of their methodology and techniques in making sure that people want to read their books. With that, the truth is compromised. And I believe that this hearings before us is not part of a theater, it's not a play. So we need to have all the reasons, genuine reasons, to be examined and to be used for the consideration of the final decision in the case. Above all else, if we look more deeply into this aspect, the information gathered by all the authors in their books, these pieces of information were collected from interviews with individuals the authors believed could provide important information to them. To that effect, who can assure or can guarantee that whatever that individual says in the interview is true? Others and the reporters are not different. They cannot claim whether the information they obtain through interviews are, is 100% true. They can only say that they have obtained these pieces of information from A or from B. That's all. Other than that, they would not be able to comment further. And if we would like to know more about this, we have to really meet those individuals personally to obtain further information or to verify the content of the information. Nonetheless, there are still some shortages. So it is really important that witnesses that appear before the chamber had to take the oath before he or she is examined. Otherwise, the information from them would not bear any property value before the chamber and, and after all cannot be used. Also, authors of the books are foreigners. They don't speak Khmer.
De plus, les auteurs de ces livres sont des étrangers qui ne parlent pas Khmer.
So the information they obtained is gathered through the interpreters.
Et donc, les informations qu'ils ont obtenues
therefore, it lacks
été rassemblées par l'intermédiaire d'interprètes.
Integrity and truth.
Et manque in conclusion, donc d'intégrité
the information obtained from interviews is nothing short of the hearsay pieces of information or evidence.
Ne constitue rien d'autre que des
and as it says in Khmer,
comme nous le disons en Khmer,
there is a folk tale about one from one crow to ten crows. And this is the same when you hear a piece of information from one person, this information can be exaggerated to 10 times bigger than the original information. And the Khmer folktale is meant to educate people not to believe in hearsay. Pieces of evidence, and it has been here in Cambodian society for all along.
Et c'est un dicton qui est bien connu
and if the chamber were to rely heavily on the hearsay pieces of evidence, I'm convinced that this court would not be able to find proper justice for every one of us. I therefore would like to reject and would like the chamber to reject all the evidence that is quoted from those books, as I cited. Third, minutes of the meetings and the documents that I was forwarded. Regarding this, the co-prosecutors also refer to these documents against me. And the references mainly refer to my presence in meetings or the document sometime entitled Copy to Uncle Chia or Nun Chia. On this, I wish to also make observation that I do not remember how many times I attended a meeting where Pol Pot attended during the time when I had worked with him. I feel, however, that some information is not true or is still questionable.
Cependant, j'ai le sentiment que certaines
nonetheless, even though
ou,
I attended any of the meetings, that doesn't mean that I engaged
si
in decision-making.
Réunions,
there were several meetings that other people attended, but it was
réunions.
Not necessary that they had to make any decision. And most of the time, attendees did not challenge a decision made in the meeting. With that, the co-prosecutors cannot conclude that because I was present in the meeting, I also engaged in decision-making. Likewise, there were other documents entitled in which I was copied. That means I did not attend such meetings or engage in any of the decision-making. Although I was copied, sometimes I did not receive such documents. Although I may know about them, I had no authority to do anything about this. I had no authority to stop people from implementing the decision. I therefore would like to contest any attempt to bring these pieces of evidence against me.
Je m'oppose donc à tout effort de verser ces
B.
documents comme pièce à charge en ce qui me concerne.
The supervisory role and my role. Once again, I would like to make it clear that during the Democratic Cambodia, I was holding three roles in particular. First, Deputy Secretary of the Democratic Cambodia. In this position, I was tasked with the roles of propagating and educate people about the policy among the members of the party. At that time, there were not many member parties. With regard to the content of the education session, I never educated members of the party to be bad people or to be misconduct, to behave improperly, for example. I educated only to people to love the nation and country and others. I never educated any member of the party to kill, mistreat, style, or to commit an act of genocide, even once. I never did that. Factually, I already mentioned that in the sessions, I educated people on how to strengthen security and safety against the enemy. I think it is not uncommon, because the leadership at all countries in the world would have to bear this responsibility to ensure that the country is well protected and security is well preserved for its own people. For example, recently, America has announced that it is hunting Edward Snowden. and they would like to send this person for prosecution as he is accused of violating the security matters of America.
Et le poursuivre.
Second,
pour
the deputy chairman of the
Deuxièmement,
committee to negotiate with the Labour Party of Vietnam. In this role, I did my best to coordinate, negotiate with Vietnam to strengthen our relationship and peace with this neighboring country. But it was not successful because Vietnam really would like to wage war and invade Cambodia. Three, I was the president of the People Representative Assembly of Cambodia. As you know, that during the Democratic Cambodia, like in the other communist country, the party leads the country, but the state was in full control of the state. And at that time, the institutions or the management of the state was seen in clear division of power. First, the executive body, legislative body, and the judiciary. Pol Pot was in charge of the executive body, when I myself was in charge of the president of the People's Representative Assembly. And in this role, I was in charge of making sure that the laws was passed. And also, since Cambodia has just recovered from war-torn phenomenon with Vietnam in particular, we did not have enough time to adopt any new laws. Regarding another role, I did never perform that role. I would like to take issue with the assertion that I used to be the deputy, the acting prime minister rather, or the person in charge of military committee, or I was involved with the supervision of S21 because I was implicated. Please be informed that Pol Pot was the deputy prime minister. Rather, Pol Pot had his deputy prime minister, who was Mr. Yeng Sary, Son Sen, and Von Wet. So, there was no reason that Pol Pot would like to appoint me as the acting prime minister apart from the deputy prime minister that I just mentioned. And it is true that he would not do that when he was absent. I would like to also solemnly declare that I engaged in the Democratic Cambodia for the purpose of liberating Cambodia and protect Cambodia from being involved. Invaded by the neighboring country. We know that this neighboring country would like to swallow Cambodia all along. I love my own people and I have no reason to mistreat or commit any crime of genocide against my own people. Finally, I would like the court to kindly consider my request regarding my rejection of all the documents presented by the co-prosecutors, and it is really important for the purpose of the truth and justice for me. Thank you very much, Mr. President, and Your Honours.
The President, thank you, Mr. Nunjia.
Le Président, merci, Monsieur Nunjia.
Before the morning break, I would like to ask the prosecutor. Yesterday, the chamber received an immediate request filed by the prosecutor to respond to document E-288/4 filed by the defense team for Mr. Kyu Sampon, dated on the 5th of July 2013. The chamber would like to know the position of the prosecutor, whether or not you are ready to respond to this document. If so, you may proceed.
Si c'est le cas, vous pouvez poursuivre.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honours. Good morning, Council, and everyone else in the courtroom. Thank you for this opportunity to make brief submissions on the filing that we all received yesterday. And let me say at the outset that we are all, certainly on this side of the courtroom, stunned by this latest and very belated change of position by the Kyu Sampon team and, of course, by the accused himself. If you permit me, I will, for context, briefly outline five requests which the Kyu Sampon team says have been rejected and which have apparently or supposedly resulted in the decision which we've been informed of. Firstly, and this is all in E-288/4 at paragraph 7, firstly, we are informed that the first primary reason for Kyu Sampon's decision not to testify is that the chamber has refused to give him a list of questions, a list of questions by topic to which he would be required to respond in court. Secondly, he says that the chamber has failed to order the provision of a list of documents which would be used in that examination, such list to be limited to what Kyu Sampon considers reasonable. Thirdly, that they have been denied a request to have 3 weeks for preparation prior to the commencement of examinations. Fourthly, that issues in relation to counsel's access to the detention unit on weekends have not been adequately resolved. And finally, even though this clearly was not refused, a request to have to give testimony only half day for each day of court sitting. So those are the five grounds as we understand them. Of course, there are other procedural complaints raised. We take issue with all of them. We find them wholly unconvincing and misleading in numerous respects, and we will file a formal written response. But those are the five key procedural concerns that apparently have led to this last-minute change of heart.
Des questions de procédure qui auraient conduit à ce changement d'avis de dernière minute.
Now, it is important, I think, given the significance of this decision, that we review briefly the procedural history of this matter. It's important to say, here in open court, with the accused present, with the victims watching, and with the Cambodian people watching this proceeding, that Kyu Sampon has stated consistently, from well before the start of this trial, that he will testify. He said that on the 13th of December 2011, when he was instructed by Your Honours to state his position. He said it earlier, in fact, also on the 23rd of November 2011, in unequivocal terms, that he will respond once he hears the evidence. That also was a position echoed by his counsel. That position remained unchanged, and in fact, Kyu Sampan has made statements, thereby giving evidence during the proceedings, and he has also, more recently, commencing on the 27th of May 2013, specifically answered questions from civil parties, thereby again giving evidence before Your Honour. Before I continue with the procedural history, I'll pause here to observe that the legal implications of Kyu Sampan's position, his statement, and his giving of evidence are that he has unilaterally and unequivocally waived his right to remain silent in this trial. He has not exercised his right to remain silent. He has, in fact, elected to give evidence and has given evidence. And that has implications for his decision now to stop testifying. And we will come to that in a few moments. Now, turning to some of the conditions that have been raised by the defence, the discussion of these conditions commenced on the 27th of May 2013. Your Honours will recall that you had instructed the accused to state their position in relation to testifying in the final stages of the trial, and you in fact gave them a weekend, a period of 3 or 4 days, to consult their counsel. And then on the 27th of May, in court, Kyu Sampan confirmed that he will be testifying, that he will be answering questions. He did at that point, and this is at time marker 9:08:01, say that he would like to know the content of the questions he would be asked. Mr. President then informed him that that would be unlikely, that an accommodation of that request would be unlikely because you can't write questions that will be asked as you would do on a blackboard in a school, that is impossible in an adversarial process. And of course, we would add, certainly departs from any international or domestic practice known to any legal system that we're aware of. Following that exchange, at 9:12:15, Mr. Verken clarified the issue and said that Mr. Kyu Sampan was not in fact asking for a list of questions, but instead, and I quote him, a general, all they want is general topics that will be brought up, as well as a list of documents. That was the position on the 27th of May. And let me say here that we, whilst a request for a list of documents and a request for topics exceed accepted international standards, we take no issue with them, and we will come back to that point when we invite Mr. Kyu Sampan to once more reconsider, perhaps for the final time, his position. These additional requests for lists of questions emerged only on the 11th of June 2013 in preparation for the trial management meeting, and this is in document E288/2, where a list of questions was raised for the first time. It's interesting that at the trial management meeting itself, on the 13th of June 2013, that issue was not again raised by the defence. There was no request for additional documents to be provided at that point. The requests at that point were for a break of 3 weeks in proceedings to enable the accused to prepare. And of course, the request had previously been made for a list of documents and a list of topics.
Et puis les demandes préalablement formulées concernant la liste de documents et liste de thèmes.
In relation to the complaint about, which is also made in this latest pleading, as to unlimited time for questioning.
Qui est soulevée ici sur la question.
Your Honours will recall that you had invited the parties to provide indication as to how much time they required. We estimated approximately six court days for the examination of Qu San Phan, and we asked for some flexibility. Your Honours, in our opinion, quite wisely, elected not to place time limits, but instead decided to obviously allow the proceedings or the examinations to continue for as long as they remained pertinent and for as long as questions were relevant. And for as long as the accused were able and willing to participate. And that, in our view, is an entirely reasonable position at this stage of the proceedings.
Ce qui nous a paru être une décision très raisonnable à cette phase du procès.
Coming back to the specific requests that have been made,
pour revenir aux requêtes spécifiques,
I want to state clearly on behalf of the Office of the Co-Prosecutors that even though these requests exceed what is accepted international practice, even though they exceed the accused's actual rights, we want to make sure that every reasonable opportunity is given to him to answer questions, as he has been promising now for almost 2 years. From our side, we are prepared to give him a list of documents, which is something your honours have already accommodated. We're also prepared to give them a list of topics that will be discussed in the examination, on the understanding that obviously the list of documents or the list of topics cannot be entirely exhausted. It can only ever be indicative, because as Mr. President has indicated, examinations are adversarial, issues can be raised by the accused, and it is impossible to provide an exhaustive list of every subtopic that may come up. But certainly we are prepared to give him a relatively detailed list that would give him a clear indication as to what topics would be discussed. That, of course, is in addition to the list of topics that is available in the closing order, which could not be clearer as to the issues that the Chamber is concerned in this trial. But we are prepared to provide that, and we will provide it within 24 hours, provided if the accused now agrees to answer questions. As for the extra time to prepare,
le délai de préparation supplémentaire,
we're in agreement with Your Honours that having had access to this file for 5 years and having participated in the trial for a year and a half, the accused is well on notice of the issues that he will be asked about.
Des questions qui seront posées.
There is really no need for extra time, but again, if Your Honours consider that that accommodation should be made, if you consider that that is something that should be attempted, then we will obviously not object. We want to make sure that he is given every conceivable opportunity and a reasonable opportunity to prepare and to answer questions as he has promised from the beginning. And here I come to the legal implications of a decision to refuse to answer questions. We, in fact, feared as early as February 2012 that we may reach this juncture. And we filed a request, which is document E174, the 17th of February 2012. In which we invited the Chamber to notify the accused as to the implications of a selective exercise of decisions as to whether or not to testify. The Chamber, having received that request, then did in fact inform all accused as to the implications of selective decisions on testimony. And Your Honours did that on the 18th of April 2012. The transcript is E1/63.1, and the specific instruction or direction is given at time marker 11:12:32. And there Your Honours clearly state that the relevant international jurisprudence indicates that adverse inferences from selective decisions to remain silent may be drawn. That instruction is entirely consistent with international jurisprudence. Once an accused gives evidence, as Q. Sampan has done in this trial, a refusal to answer questions can lead, and in our respectful submission, now must lead to adverse inferences being drawn on the evidence against him. And we want to state that now, because we have in fact reached a stage where this is not a hypothetical scenario, but in fact an apparently firm decision now by the accused to reverse his course. And I will refer Your Honours to only two or three authorities on this matter. The first authority comes from the International Criminal Court. It's a decision of the 13th of September 2011 in the case of Katanga.
Dans l'affaire Katanga.
And the relevant paragraphs are paragraphs 7 and 8, where it is made clear that once an accused testifies or gives evidence, his or her decision to decline to answer further questions may lead to adverse inferences being drawn, again, consistent with Your Honour's ruling. The second authority is Prosecutor and Blagojevich, an ICTY decision of the 30th of July 2004, where the trial chamber of the ICTY gave notice of rights to the accused, and you will find at paragraph 24 that this position is stated in relation to adverse inferences. More broadly, this principle applies in domestic legal systems and has been upheld also by the European Court of Human Rights, and you will find, Your Honours, in the decision of Murray and the United Kingdom, a decision of the 8th of February 1996, that the principle is upheld that a right to silence is not an absolute right and that in certain circumstances an adverse inference can be drawn on the evidence against the accused. So our respectful application is in two parts, Your Honours. One is that Your Honours consider allowing these additional accommodations that we have now indicated as to lists of questions and as to lists of, rather lists of topics and lists of documents, as well as, if Your Honours consider it appropriate, a period of time, 2 or 3 weeks, as Your Honours find suitable for preparation, so that there can be no suggestion that any opportunity to prepare was denied, and that the accused now be requested to state once and for all, clearly in court, with these accommodations having been made, whether or not he will answer questions. And the second part of our applications, Your Honours, is that if he then states that he will not testify, that Your Honours confirm your prior notice and in fact now specifically warn him that adverse inferences will be drawn against him on the evidence when you deliberate in your consideration of a judgment in this case. Those are our respectful submissions.
Voilà.
We're at your disposal, of course, if there are any questions that you wish us to address.
Nous sommes prêts à répondre à toute question complémentaire.
The President, thank you, Mr. Prosecutor, and Madame Lead Co-Lawyer for the Civil Party.
La parole est à la co-avocate principale pour les parties civiles.
Oui, merci, Monsieur le Président.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President. I would like simply to add
a
few words in the interest of the civil parties following the decision taken by
Que Sampan
and his defense team. Il va sans dire que de notre côté, nous regrettons infiniment cette décision qui nous a été annoncée hier, et nous la regrettons d'autant que nous avons pu, après l'audience qui s'est déroulée fin mai et début juin, avec les parties civiles, mesurer l'importance du fait que M. Sampan avait à ce moment-là accepté de répondre aux questions des parties civiles, et nous sommes donc tout à fait conscients de l'importance de cette prise de parole d'un accusé face aux parties civiles. Alors, M. Kusampan se présente aujourd'hui comme un accusé sans voix, contraint de garder silence. Nous admettons parfaitement le droit de garder silence d'un accusé, mais nous nous rappelons aussi les propos de M. Kusampan, qui ont été rappelés par M. le procureur. M. Kusampan a toujours dit qu'à la fin des débats, il prendrait la parole et il répondrait à des questions. Et il répondrait à des questions. Nous pensons, comme Monsieur le Procureur, qu'en termes de préparation de ces questions, Monsieur Kusampan n'est pas différent des autres ici. Il y a un procès qui dure depuis 5 ans, avec une phase d'instruction qui a permis aussi à Monsieur Kusampan de préparer sa défense et de préparer ses réponses et ses explications à la fin du procès. Nous pensons que les contraintes dont il fait état dans sa requête sont les mêmes pour tous ici. Obstacles he's speaking about at the end of the request are the same for everyone here, problems of staff, problems of numbers of documents, and this is what we all are facing here. En ce qui concerne le temps de questionnement que l'équipe de Kusampan envisage comme très long, j'ai compris 4 semaines au minimum, voire davantage, je crois que c'est inexact. J'avais compris la décision de la Chambre de ne pas limiter ce temps comme une décision qui était également dans l'intérêt des accusés, dans le sens que la Chambre voulait permettre aux accusés de prendre le temps, de se reposer si nécessaire, et de se taire éventuellement à un moment donné si souhaitaient mettre un terme à ces questions. Donc je ne crois pas que le fait que la Chambre indique que le temps est illimité that the fact that time is illimited is something that is contrary to or that is against that contradicts the rights of the accused.
Je voudrais également souligner
I also
que
like to stress that
répondre à des questions de mon point de vue,
as far as I'm concerned, answering questions does not mean
only
meeting the interests of the prosecution and of the civil parties, but it's also in the interest of the accused persons, and here I would like to support what the prosecutor said before. And beyond that, even I think it's the moment for someone who states to be innocent to come provide answers and explanations.
Et je crois que c'est son intérêt et sans doute une occasion importante pour lui de faire ceci.
An important opportunity for him as well.
J'en aurais terminé en
and I will finish
revenant à ce que j'ai dit en premier.
Now, returning to what I said at the start of my submission,
j'ai cru comprendre que M. Kusampan était désireux de répondre aux parties civiles.
That Kusampan wished to answer the civil parties originally,
je suis and therefore, presque persuadé
I am almost convinced now
qu'il souhaite malgré tout répondre à des questions dans la mesure du possible.
Questions insofar as that is possible.
Je crois que c'est un rendez-vous important qui lui est donné et qui l'a donné non seulement aux parties civiles, mais aux Cambodgiens.
Et
je crois qu'il serait dommage qu'il manque ce rendez-vous. Je préciserai qu'en ce qui nous concerne, nous communiquons bien sûr nos questions à l'avance, la liste de nos questions à l'avance, et nous entendons bien sûr
of course we intend
poser ces questions dans un délai raisonnable
within a reasonable amount of
et ne
time,
pas nous étendre indéfiniment sur des sujets
dwell
sans intérêt.
On topics that are
donc nous
useless.
Avons tout à fait conscience qu'il n'est pas
aware that it is
de questionner
out of the question
pendant un temps
to question,
indéfini et inutile.
During, an indefinite amount of time,
j'espère
which would be useless.
Que M. Kusampan so sera en mesure de revenir sur cette décision,
will be,
c'est en tout cas ce que nous souhaitons vivement.
To reconsider his decision. In any case, that is what we hope.
The President, thank you. We would like to hear from counsels for Mr. Kusampan and Mr. Kusampan himself what they would like to respond to the observations
et de Kusampan
made by
lui-même.
Counsels across the bench.
Souhaitez-vous répondre?
Oui. Nous avons déposé une notice pour expliquer notre position de manière très claire.
In a very clear way.
Donc je ne pense pas que vous attendiez, Monsieur le Président, maintenant que je répète tout le contenu de cette écriture de 11 pages,
11 page, submission.
À entendre mes confrères de l'autre côté de la barre, nous ne sommes plus ici au cours d'un procès, mais il s'agit d'une conférence internationale sur l'histoire du Cambodge, et nous comprenons absolument pas
on the history
pourquoi
of Cambodia, and I don't understand why
Kyusampan
would have the slightest inhibition about expressing himself.
C'est bien évidemment une vision de circonstance, la
vérité, circumstantial
ce qui se tient
opinion,
ici dans cette
the
salle,
truth of what's happening
c'est un procès
is that we are
que
in a
nous
trial,
avons formulé des demandes
and, we have made simple
que toutes ces demandes ont été rejetées par notre chambre,
chamber,
que nous estimons que ces rejets bafouent les droits les plus élémentaires de M. Kyusampan, et qu'à partir de là,
our client, and therefore on this basis continuing
to accept to participate
in this
ces audiences ne correspond à rien
hearings
pour lui
does not mean anything
décision,
for him right now
monsieur Kyusampan l'a prise
monsieur Kyusampan took his decision
lui-même
on his own
il voudra peut-être vous en dire
and
un mot
maybe he
je crois
will
que
share a few words
détail,
about this with
nos
you
écritures
but as far as the detail is concerned in our submission E288/4 everything is very clear.
The President.
Le Président.
Thank you, Counsel.
Merci, Maître.
Mr. Kyusampan, would
Monsieur
you
Kyusampan,
wish
est-ce que
to
vous
respond to the observations made by the co-prosecutors and legal lawyer for the
civil parties?
Mr. Kyusampan,
civils?
Good morning, Mr. President, and your honors.
Bonjour, Monsieur le Président, Mesdames, Messieurs les
and
juges.
Good morning, everyone in and
bonjour
around
à toutes les
the
personnes
courtroom.
Ici présentes.
I would like to inform you that I have reasons
je souhaite
that
vous
I have
informer
decided to exercise
que
my
si
right to remain silent.
Mon droit
the reason
garder le silence c'est pour certaines raisons.
Because
ces raisons sont les suivantes.
The court has failed to respect my rights.
La chambre n'a pas respecté
and
mes
the
droits
rights of my defense counsels.
Et ceux de ma défense.
At the beginning, I had faith in
initialement,
this court,
je faisais,
but
je plaçais ma foi
after that,
dans ce tribunal.
Until the last moment, I have no faith in
mais
this court.
Ensuite, j'ai perdu cette foi.
That is all, Mr. President.
C'est tout, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you.
Merci.
The President, thank you, Mr. Kyusampan.
It
is now
merci
appropriate
Monsieur
moment for adjournment. The chamber will adjourn until
nous allons observer une pause.
11 o'clock.
L'audience reprendra à 11 heures. Suspension de l'audience.
Some change culture.